We thought a pint would be a nice way to break the ice.
Okay, sort of get him to loosen up.
No, but in all seriousness, not many people know this, but Guy Hans made one of his first small fortunes actually investing in bars in England. He rolled up small pubs and consolidated them essentially and then sold them.
Okay, all right, well, makes sense. A good backdrop for him, though. So he hasn't spoken up publicly since the financial crisis. So why is he doing this now?
Well, first off, Betty, it was fascinating to sit down with one of the biggest brands in European private equity. This is a guy that people thought would shun the public for a very long time because of that failed investment that you mentioned, record company EMI. His firm took a huge hit on that. And you ask, why now? Because he basically thinks there's enough daylight between the negative headlines associated with EMI and sort of more positive recent developments. Mm-hmm. You know, he has other investments, and those investments look like they could be sold at a profit. I don't know if you know this, but his firm is actually the biggest landowner, residential landowner in Germany. So, and he's looking to take that company public. He also owns Odeon Cinemas. Terra Firma owns Odeon Cinemas. They're looking to sell that company. So they're looking forward to some very positive news in the coming months.
Well, what does he say about Europe, about the macro outlook for Europe then?
It's very interesting to hear him talk about Europe because he's lived in England for so long and he has a very unique perspective. Look, he said, investors are just going to have to get used to this volatility and we're going to see the European crisis play out for much longer than people anticipate just because of the European culture. They like to hang on to their institutions, they like to hang on to their lifestyles, and they're not going to rip the Band-Aid off like America did. So watch this play out over a longer period of time. You know, Betty, he doesn't have as much money as he would like to have to put to work right now, but he did say the opportunities right now in Europe would mainly lie in Germany and England.
Okay, Germany and England certainly seems like the two growth countries, essentially.